this political party, it is your time to hold the rally here. You there, tomorrow here. Now, if you don't follow that, you will have chaos. And we cannot allow chaos just because you are pretending to be a political leader. You must follow order.
More than just jail and cracking down on dissent, we have even bloodshed in Uganda.
The what?
In bloodshed.
Bloodshed?
Yes, in western Uganda.
Mm.
In Rwenzururu area.
Rwenzori?
Yes. Just a few months ago, more than 100 people were killed by security forces who attacked a traditional cultural kingdom in the area, saying that that place has terrorists inside it.
Yes.
What do you say to this? Terrorists?
That issue is in court, and according to our law, when something is in court, I'm not allowed to comment. The court will tell us whether those people were arrested for nothing or not.
We're talking about those who were killed, not those who are now in court.
Yes, even the ones who were killed, whether they were killed for no reason, we shall find out from the court, because it is in the court now.
Mm-hmm.
We call it a principle of sub judice. Because if I start saying they were wrong, they were this, they were this, they were this, giving the reasons, then I'm interfering with the court.
Yeah, but with the international
what I can tell you is that since the matter is in the court, you bring all your cameras, come to the court, and film what those people are saying. You will get the facts.
Yes.
I invite you.
But we here and our audience, in the international audience of Al Jazeera, we don't know what happened. We're not going to be in the court to see it. We want you, Mr. President, to explain to us why you sent your troops to that area, to Kasese, to kill more than 100 people.
Because they were breaking the law. They were making a...
In what manner? They were...
That will come in the court.
They were just guarding the palace and they didn't even have weapons,
First of all, the kings in Uganda, we have got many kings. They are not guarded by militias. They are guarded by the national...
Just because he is guarded, you think that's dissent?
Well, I'm just giving you facts. Kings are guarded by the national army, not by a militia. So if you say there was a militia guarding, then already you're getting yourself...
But they're not armed. They have machetes. They just wanted to protect the palace.
Those facts will come in the court. The court is open. You are most welcome.
According to the reports we have, the king was persecuted and those people were killed because they opposed the president in the election. Because they are not pro the ruling government.
Not at all. There are so many. And if they opposed the president, what were the militia doing? What were the militia doing? Do political parties have militias? According to what you hear in a democracy.
If a militia is not armed and if it is not killing people, then what's the problem, Mr. President?
Where you come to the court, you would hear why those people were...
The man who led the assault on Kasese, his name is Peter Elwelu, he was a brigadier in the army at the time. Mm. And instead of him being now in the court, he was promoted general and he is now the commander of the land forces.
Yes.
Why, if you have those people in the court, why don't you also have the man who opened fire on your citizens alongside those people in the court now to answer to the questions?
That means he was doing his duty.
Duty to kill?
To
he killed more than 100 people.
To deal with...
And now he's promoted.
Yes, I am the one who promoted
him. And 2 days ago, the U.S. government refused. They blocked his going to Malawi to attend a conference on security because of that.
I don't know about the United States. Uganda is big enough for Major General Elwelu to operate there. I don't know why he's dying to go to the United States. But
no, he's not going. He was going to Malawi and he was blocked by the Americans because they are supervising that conference because of what he did in Kasese. So he's accused.
Well, I am not a prefect about American actions. I am a leader of Uganda. And I'm telling you that Elwelu did his duty and there's now peace in that area.
So it was pacified?
It was crushed. It was definitely justified, but all this will come in the court.
So, President, it seems that Ugandans are a little bit fed up with you because we are reading a lot.